पवन कुमार जी, पवन कुमार वर्मा।
धन्यवाद उपसभापति जी। मैं सोचता हूं कि अब इस बजट पे क्या चर्चा हो। आम आदमी कह रहा है कि कहने को तो बहुत कुछ था, अगर कहने पे आते। अपनी तो यह आदत है कि हम कुछ नहीं कहते, पर उसके जहन और दिमाग और दिल में बहुत से सवाल गूंज रहे हैं, और मैं चाहता हूं कि उन सवालों को सच्चाई क्या है और दावा क्या है, हकीकत क्या है और सपना क्या है, ये जो एक सीरियस संवाद होने की जरूरत है, क्योंकि बजट एक इंपॉर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट है। और जो सवाल इस समय आम नागरिक के दिमाग और जहन और दिल में है, उनको मैं जुबान देना चाहता हूं आपके माध्यम से। तो मैंने सोचा कि आज इस बजट पर टिप्पणी मैं इस तरह से करूं कि इस सदन में मैं 10 सवाल आपके सामने, आपके जरिए इस सरकार के सामने रखना चाहता हूं। मिस्टर चेयरमैन, दिस इज अ मिस्टिफाइंग बजट। द बजट क्लेम्स दैट द इकोनॉमी हैज एक्सेलरेटेड टू 7.6%। It further says that India is hailed as a bright spot amidst a slowing global economy. Robust growth has been achieved despite very unfavorable global conditions. I want to ask, Mr. Chairman, where is this growth visible? Exports have been sinking for 14 months in a row and are now down by 13.6%. There is a contraction in industrial production, and for the last 3 months, industrial production is falling. Agricultural growth is well below 2%. In the last year, it was 0.02%. The banking sector is in a mess. Investments in the first 8 months of 2015 were down by 30% compared to last year. Net sales of firms have fallen by 6%. The position of the manufacturing sector in particular, sir, is very bleak. It is down by 11.5%. And there is poor demand in the economy. ये सारे आंकड़े आपके सामने, और सरकार फिर भी कह रही है कि जो इस वक्त आर्थिक स्थिति है वो बड़ी रोबस्ट है, और 7.6% ग्रोथ पे हिंदुस्तान जो है, भारत जो है, वो एक सितारे की तरह टिमटिमा रहा है दुनिया में। मैं पूछना चाहता हूं कि आंकड़े एक तरफ हैं और सच्चाई जो है उसका वो जवाब दे दें, ये आम आदमी भी पूछ रहा है। दूसरा सवाल, सर, दिस बजट सेज दैट द एग्रीकल्चरल इनकम, इसका और वक्ताओं ने भी जिक्र किया, that the agricultural income will double by the year 2022. Is pe bahut charcha ho chuki hai, sir. I want to understand, because I think the ordinary farmer is asking, what does this mean? Sir, the economic survey says, according to NSS data, the average annual income of the medium farmer, net of production costs from cultivation, is less than rupees 20,000. Annual income is less than rupees 20,000 in 17 states. Agar kisan ki salana income 20,000 rupees, aap usko duna kar dijiye, to 40,000 rupees ho gayi. To wo prati maah 3,500 rupees kamayega. Aur agar inflation ko factor kar lijiye, to usko kya mila? आपने कौन सा सपना उजागर किया है कि यू विल गोइंग टू डबल इनकम्स? आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू, सर, हाफ ऑफ ऑल फार्मर्स इन आर कंट्री आर अंडर अ पर कैपिटल डेट ऑफ रुपीज 47,000. योर आंसर इज दैट वी विल गिव देम क्रेडिट। द फार्मर्स आर ऑलरेडी इन डेट एंड यू विल गिव देम क्रेडिट, एंड द बैंक्स दैट विल गिव देम क्रेडिट आर ऑलरेडी इन क्लोज टू बैंक्रप्सी। What is this kind of promise and what is this kind of dream? Then you have said that we have given you an agricultural oriented budget. I just want to quote facts to you, sir. It's easy to make arguments, it's easy to lampoon each other. Sir, in the year 2005, the allocation for agriculture was 36,355 crores. In 2014, you brought it down to 27,000 crores. And this time you have raised it to 35,000 crores. So in effect, for a budget which claims to be an agriculturally oriented budget, your allocation for agriculture is less than what was there in 2005. And this is happening when there have been 2 years of successive droughts. Every half an hour, a farmer is committing suicide. There have been 124 suicides this year in Maharashtra alone. There are higher input costs. Fertilizer prices have gone up. Riots have taken place over one bag of urea. And your promise on the MSP has been blatantly betrayed. And you are saying that you will double agricultural income by 2022. Is this another Chunavi Jumla? People are asking this question. If today agricultural production is growing by less than 2%, last year it was even below 1%. What is the rate of growth agriculture must see in order to double by 2022? Do you have an agricultural roadmap? Bihar, sir, Bihar, I say this not because I want to speak parochially, but in Bihar we set up a mission for preparing an agricultural roadmap, including investigating subsidized seed, training of farmers, increasing private participation in the seed market, and a whole range of issues which encapsulated warehousing, cold storages, R&D, better seeds, fertilizers. There is the need to boost agricultural productivity, whereas you are translating it into a simple promise. हम 2022 तक एग्रीकल्चरल इनकम और फार्मर की इनकम को डबल कर देंगे। So that is my second question. Sir, my third question, and I raised this because it was an important question about jobs. अभी नरेश जी ने भी उसका जिक्र किया। चुनाव के समय आपने कहा कि हम 2 करोड़ नौकरियां देंगे। इस देश का जो युवा तबका है, वो इसका इंतजार करता रहा। Sir, jobs ki sthiti ye hai, and I'm putting it on record before the house. You need the manufacturing sector for job, for low-skilled absorption of those leaving agriculture. But job creation in the manufacturing sector and in the export sector fell by a net 43,000 in the last year, the worst performance in 6 years. तो आप जॉब्स कहां से क्रिएट कर रहे हैं और आपने अगर इस तरह के वायदे किए थे तो अब सिचुएशन क्या है क्योंकि जो हमारे द यूथ ऑफ आवर कंट्री इज स्टिल वेटिंग उनके जबान पे वो जो पुराना शेर है कि हमने जाके देख लिया है राह गुजर के आगे भी राह गुजर ही राह गुजर है राह गुजर के आगे भी अब कब तक इंतजार करेंगे यू हैव मेड द प्रॉमिस You have failed to fulfill it. In fact, you have done worse than any other government in the last 6 years. So I'm asking you, statistics or statistics, you can juggle them about. But what is the gap between the truth and your claim? My fourth question, sir, relates to inflation. Sir, inflation mein, abhi phir uska zikr hua because we repeat ourselves. But there is no doubt that there is general disappointment about the fact that a favorable international climate where the prices of crude oil have fallen to historically low levels have not been passed on to the consumer. And sir, I don't understand. I'm not an economist. This great distinction between WPI and CPI. Aap shayad samajhte honge, Upsabhapati ji, hum log to samajhte nahi. Kyunki agar aap bazaar mein jayein, January mein the price of vegetables One went up by 12.52%. Food price inflation is at 6.7%. Aapne cess laga diye arbitrary. Service tax bada diya hai. तो ये जो इन्फ्लेशन है वो कहां से कम हुआ है? एंड आई वांट टू से टू यू सर दैट देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन इन्फ्लेशन एंड महंगाई. इन्फ्लेशन में भी स्टेटिस्टिकली गोइंग डाउन, पर महंगाई जो एक चीज है वो तब आदमी को महसूस होती है, गृहिणी को महसूस होती है, जबकि उसका परचेजिंग पावर श्रिंक कर रहा होता है. व्हेन परचेजिंग पावर श्रिंक्स, इवन इफ स्टेटिस्टिक्स शो प्राइसेस आर फॉलिंग, देयर इज अ सेंस दैट प्राइसेस आर इंक्रीजिंग. सो आई एम सेइंग टू यू व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन विथ रिगार्ड टू इन्फ्लेशन. सर माय फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन रिलेट्स टू बैंक्स. You have made a token contribution for the recapitalization of banks of 25,000 crores. I ask you, when the NPA itself is over 4 lakh crores, could you not in the budget have provided a roadmap for the revitalization of the entire banking industry? It needs application of mind, innovative thought, a sense of taking even risks. But you have created an infrastructure in the banking sector where you have finally resorted to the tokenism. I agree that recapitalization is not the only methodology, but you have to actually find solution. You are standing still and creating the impression of movement. My sixth question, sir, says is really kina khuda hi mila na visale sanam. गरीब लोगों की जो हालत है वो तो आपने देख ली, किसानों को तो आपने सपना दिया. आज किसान कह रहा है हमको मालूम है जन्नत की हकीकत, लेकिन दिल बहलाने को गालिब ये ख्याल अच्छा है. बहुत बढ़िया, ये किसान कह रहा है आज, क्योंकि आप कहते हो रूरल सेक्टर का बजट. तो न तो आपने उनकी मदद की और न ही आपने कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर की मदद की, न मध्यवर्ग की. कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर की अब यह हालत है और मैं आपके सामने रखता हूं इस बात को. कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर में आपने कॉरपोरेट टैक्सेशन जिसका वादा किया था कि कम कर देंगे, वो नहीं किया. ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस में आपने कहते हैं हमने बहुत कुछ कर लिया, 142 नंबर पर देश पे था भारत, अब 130 नंबर पे आ गया है. एंड यू आर क्लेमिंग इट एज अ बिग सक्सेस. वी आर 155th पोजिशन इन द वर्ल्ड इन ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस. द फियर ऑफ रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव टैक्सेशन हैज नॉट बीन रिमूव्ड. The dividend distribution tax has been introduced. So I ask you, and the middle class, of course, has got no real relief in taxation in it. But on the other hand, you had put the taxation even on the provident fund, which, as a matter of great tactical policy, then you made the effort to withdraw. I am saying to you, you haven't done anything for the poor. You haven't done anything for the rich. Who have you done it for? So my seventh question relates to, very briefly, least developed states and regional equitable development. I want to say to you that there are large swathes of this country which are backward, not because of their own doing, but because of the legacy of the past.
Can you do it? You do it.
How has your budget contributed?
Special mention.
How has your budget contributed to lessening this gap in terms of regional development? So my eighth question relates
special
to...
Special mention distribute karo.
Mr. Chairman, sir, I crave your indulgence.
List de do.
Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir. Sir, my eighth question... Sir, look at the watch, but I also need your attention. The eighth question relates to the social sector. I think there is no budget presented so far where there was such a crying need for greater investment in this sector when the total cumulative... percentage on social sector is less than 2%. अभी मंत्री जी ने आज सुबह क्वेश्चन आवर में कहा कि हमारे पास पैसों की कोई कमी नहीं है. या तो उनका परिस्थितियों से समझौता है या केंद्र मंत्री की हैसियत में उनकी वफादारी की नई मिसाल है. The truth is that the social sector, education and health are being starved. Sir, my ninth question relates to very small point, it will take 10 seconds only. Sir, you are talking of FDI. I want to say to you, FDI may have shown a slight increase, but investors in this country, okay, and this is not an economic argument. Look at a nation also.
You can continue your speech tomorrow. No, time. You
sir,
can continue your speech tomorrow.
Sir, I'm just finishing.
I tell you.
Sir, I'm finishing.
I'm telling you, you continue your speech tomorrow.
No, sir. I'll finish.
I am telling you.
I'll take 2
you
minutes.
You are to control. I am... Sir, I will decide. What are you doing? Sir, you continue tomorrow.
Sir, I'll take 2 minutes. Sir.
No, I am saying you continue tomorrow. Sit down. Why are you doing like this? Let him continue or not continue, I have to decide. No, that I will decide, I am here. This kind of intervention is not good. Now, the message from Lok Sabha.
I beg to report that the Lok Sabha at its sitting held on the 15th of March 2016 had agreed to the amendments made by the Rajya Sabha to the National Waterways Bill 2016 passed by the Rajya Sabha at its sitting held on the 9th of March 2016.
Now, special mention, those who could not place yesterday. Yesterday, the called and they can. Those who could not place yesterday, from the yesterday's list. Yes. No. Those who are absent yesterday, I permit you. Yeah.
Mohday, my desh mein...
You place, lay on the table. Yeah, you can lay on the table, that's all.
Sir, just 1 minute is a very important issue.
No, 5 minutes. You can say the subject and lay on the table.
Sir, mera ye jo special mention hai, ye avashyak dawaiyon
ke Sanjay Rao,
vriddhi ke bare mein.
Sit down, that's enough. Sanjay Rao? No. Sri Palvi Govind Reddy? No. Sri Mohammad Nadimul Haq? No. Sri Ram Kumar Kashyap? No. Dr. Sanjay Singh? No. Sri Shandaram Nayak?
Yes, sir. I lay on the table of the house.
Yes. Sri Anupama Mohandi? No. Sri K. R. Arjunan? No. Sri Thangavelu? Yes. Say you will lay on the table. You have to say you lay on the table. Yes, sir. Mr. Thangavelu, you have to say you lay on the table. Yes. Okay. Sri. Now, Chaudhary Manuvar Salim? Yes. Say it, I lay on the table. Sri C.P. Narayanan? Yes. Srimadi Kakashan Pavin? Yes. Then Sri K.C. Tyagi? No. Sri Ambath Rajan? Yes, lay on the table. Sri Mansukh Lal Mandavia? No. Sri Vijay Jawalar Darda? Already done. Sri Kanak Lata Singh? Sri Avinash Rai Khanna? Yes, laid on the table. Sri Motilal Vora? Absent. Sri Srimad Renuka Chaudhary? Absent. Oh, yes. Sri Arjunan? Laid on the table. Anybody else? Anybody else?
Anupam Mohanty.
Anupam Mohanty?
Sir, I lay on the table, sir.
Yes, fine. You are... No, it is special mention.
No, not called, sir.
Now it is 4 o'clock. It is time for the farewell function. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.